Blackstone Publishing presents Not Quite Mastering the Art of French Living by Mark Greenside. This book is read by Richard Poe. To Donna Umeki, my wife. Note to the reader. If you're lucky, some of the things that happen to me will happen to you. If you're luckier, some of them won't. Several names of people and places have been changed to protect them and me from everyone. Forward. In the spring of 1991, against my wishes and all my judgments, my girlfriend persuaded me to spend the summer in Brittany, Finistère, the end of the world. I wanted to go to Saskatchewan, where people speak English, where I could get to by driving instead of flying, and where Americans, if not actually liked, weren't actually hated. This isn't the last time I was wrong. We rented a house in Plobien, a village of about 600 people, from an English lady named Sally, and within days I fell under Brittany's spell. Its shimmering light, white cotton candy clouds, and blue-green sea. Its granite viaducts and dolmen, ambling rivers, heathered hills, huge skies, beaches and tides. I met Monsieur and Madame P. and their two sons, Henri and Philippe. Madame was the keeper of the keys to Chez Sally and the knower of everything I needed to know, my first friend and future Aladdin and guardian angel. I also met Jean and Sharon and their boys, Jan and Noe. Jean is Breton, a filmmaker. Sharon is Canadian, Quebecois, a painter and teacher. They are soixante-huitards, 60s folks like me, and unlike Monsieur and Madame P, fluent in English. She from birth, he from her. As it turned out, 8 weeks were 4 weeks too many for my girlfriend and me. By the end of the summer, I was out of love with her, in love with Brittany, and ready to return to California. Then I bought a house in France. I, who don't speak French, don't like to fly, who owned nothing at the time but the clothes in my closet and an 18-year-old Volvo, borrowed money from my mom and bought a 120-year-old stone house, 6,000 miles and 21 hours, door to door from California. That was 20-plus years ago, and I've never regretted it, which I can't say about a lot of things I've done. Over the years, I've met and become friends with many people. Bruno, Francoise, Gilles, Tatiana, Hugo, Nadine, Jean-Pierre, Joël, Ella, Rick, Martin, Louise, Sally, and Monsieur Charles. These people, along with Monsieur and Madame P, and Sharon and Jean, have become my family and have served as a combination Red Cross and Salvation Army, as they have repeatedly saved and rescued me, mostly from myself. More than they can believe and I want to remember. All of them are in this book, along with my American friends Peggy, Leroy, Jerry, Cheryl, Bob, Lonnie, and Donna, who entered my life and changed it forever, for better, and who unbelievably speaks French, likes France, and agreed to marry me and live part of every summer in Plobien. This is my world, the old world that is constantly new to me. I've been coming to France, Brittany, for more than 20 years now, and I'm still trying to master the art of French living. For a guy who likes to think he knows what he's doing, it's been an unexpectedly bumpy ride. Driving me nuts. I started driving when I was 17 and had my first accident when I was 17 and a half. I'd successfully completed driver's education in high school and was convinced I knew what I was doing, which is often the first and best sign that I don't. In those days, driving was a sign of adulthood, manhood, even more than sexual experience, probably because it was easier to get a car than a girl, and definitely easier than getting a girl into a car, which was my chief aim at the time. My driver's ed teacher was Mr. F., a pleasant man who was also a history teacher and tennis coach. He liked teaching driver's ed most because it was where he could pay the least attention. I passed the class easily. We all did, but I didn't learn anything about driving, or safety, or sanity, or adulthood. No one did, which is why I had the accident. It was 1:30 in the morning. I had just dropped Shelley Greben at her house after summoning the courage of Jeanne d'Arc, Socrates, Galileo, and Shackleton to kiss her under the strobe lamp her parents left on to dissuade her or me or us. I was elated. Having accomplished my two chief goals in life, getting a girl into my car and kissing her.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.